This video is brought to you by VIRCI, a science and technology company offering research and development and consulting. The Dinosaur Bonsai Apocalypse book presents a new hypothesis on the causes of the dinosaur extinction, introducing new ideas in addition to the two main accepted theories, the asteroid impact and volcanic eruptions. One of the main observations and characteristics of the dinosaur age is the large size of the dinosaur animal species at that time period. During the writing of the first two books in this astronomy series, I concluded that Earth is constantly increasing in size, as a growing organism does. Earth's diameter and outer shell and mantle are in constant expansion, similar to the effect on the surface of an inflating balloon, as explained in the Expanding Earth video. I also came to the conclusion that as Earth expands and increases in size, this would have an effect of changing the level or force of the magnetosphere, which in turn would affect the gravity force level and atmospheric pressure on Earth's surface. Gravity levels are not uniform throughout the solar system and the universe. It is affected by many factors, mainly A. mass, size, and composition of a celestial body, B. the scalar electromagnetic fields and forces, and C. space, time, pressure, and displacement of the vacuum or ether. And more factors as explained in the gravity chapter of my first book, Carradine's Rosetta Stone of Astronomy. This led me to deduce that a change to the magnetosphere, which in turn affected the atmospheric pressure and gravity force levels, took place in Earth's past caused by an expanding Earth mass, which in turn had a major role in the extinction of the dinosaurs. Large dinosaurs cannot survive on Earth in its current size, gravity level, and/or atmospheric pressure, because the current gravity and pressures on Earth would be detrimental to the bone structure and possibly cause many serious health factors to large dinosaurs and large animal species. An expanding Earth would cause the magnetosphere, the atmospheric pressure, and the gravity levels to change, with the exception of whales and other large aquatic creatures that live in water bodies, which puts them on a different level of pressure and environment. The following are the six major factors and potential causes to the dinosaur apocalypse. 1. The bonsai effect on life forms caused by the changing levels of the magnetosphere, atmospheric pressure, and gravity due to a growing and expanding Earth mass. 2. The moon factor, caused by a cataclysmic celestial event by which our moon was changed or swapped. This would lead to a change in Earth's axial spin speed and electromagnetic levels due to the change in the three-part homopolar generator effect, where the solid inner core, the sun's electric current, and the moon play a major factor in generating the magnetosphere and atmosphere. 3. Large-scale volcanic eruptions throughout the planet caused by major Earth changes due to an expanding Earth and/or moon change. 4. Asteroid impact causing a mini ice age, which is the currently accepted theory. 5. A magnetic pole shift causing a mini ice age. And 6. A combination of two or more of the previously mentioned events, bringing about the demise of the dinosaurs. In the bonsai art of agronomy, trees are manipulated to grow at a miniature scale, and even the fruits that the bonsai trees produce are much smaller and to scale of the bonsai tree. I use the bonsai effect as a reference and a metaphor to better visualize the possibility of the shrinking effect on plant life and animal species. However, the science of the bonsai art is different from the factors that cause the changes to the atmosphere, magnetosphere, and gravity pressure on Earth due to an expanding globe. The discovery of the expanding Earth diameter led me to conclude that a change in the magnetosphere, atmospheric pressure, and gravity strength had occurred in Earth's past, approximately 66 million years ago, and that would have had a bonsai-like effect on living species on Earth by causing the decrease of the size of most past existing large species. The decrease in size could be due to an increase in the atmospheric pressure and gravity force, which puts pressure on new growing species. For example, when deep sea animals are caught and they are brought up to the surface, they expand greatly in size due to the pressure change. The bonsai effect could be caused by different events. It could be a fast bonsai event caused by a cataclysmic event wiping out most large animal species, followed immediately by a major change in atmospheric pressure, the magnetosphere, and gravity levels, in which the size of the new animal species would be affected and limited accordingly and immediately. Or a slow bonsai event caused by an extended cataclysmic event wiping out most large animal species, followed by a slow, gradual change in atmospheric pressures, the magnetosphere, and gravity levels, in which the size of the new animal species would be affected and limited gradually. The fast bonsai effect is the most likely scenario due to the fossil records showing a fast extinction. The decrease in the size of animal life forms could have been a slow, gradual evolutionary process through hundreds of thousands of years, or a fast change caused by one or more of the factors stated in this chapter. This hypothesis explains the major anomaly of the size difference of the terrestrial animals from the dinosaur age to the present day, and how some animals like elephants, birds, and reptiles were almost identical to their predecessors, but are of much smaller size now. And the decrease in size of life forms is not restricted to animals. There is also evidence of ancient giant trees and plant forms throughout the planet. By reviewing historical evidence from indigenous tribes in written history from old cultures, we may find references to a difference in the alignment of Earth with other planets. And there's even a mention of a period of Earth without a moon. In the first chapters of the Dinosaur Bonsai Apocalypse book, I explained the importance of the moon in conjunction with Earth and the sun in creating the electromagnetic effect through the three-part generator force and its effect on atmosphere, magnetosphere, and gravity on Earth. A cataclysmic celestial event that wiped out rapidly or gradually the dinosaurs, in addition to an expanding Earth, probably happened in Earth's past. The scientist and writer Emanuel Velikovsky, in his book Worlds in Collision, describes a cataclysmic celestial event that had a major destructive and realignment effect on our solar system. My conclusion is that Earth had a different moon than our current moon. Something cataclysmic probably happened to reshuffle the planetary alignment. The cataclysmic event could have caused Earth's old moon to A. be ejected out of the solar system, B. to jump inward towards the sun and get locked in orbit of the sun, or C. to jump outward away from the sun and get locked into orbit of a neighboring planet. Or the new or current moon could have been a neighboring planet's moon, such as Mars, and through the celestial reshuffle could have gotten locked onto Earth's orbit. Or instead, the current moon could have come from outside our solar system and captured by Earth's gravitational grip. Historical and ancient Greek mythology has reference to Mars having intelligent life and civilization. It is possible that Mars could have lost its moon to Earth. A moon change on Mars would have been an apocalyptic event that would have wiped out most life on Mars. I hypothesize that the size and mass of Mars' current moons are not adequate enough to generate the right level of magnetosphere through the three-part homopolar generator effect that would protect its atmosphere to sustain life form as we know it on Earth, as explained in the first chapters. As an example, planet Venus seems to resemble and behave more like a moon than as a planet. Planet Venus does have a two-way gravitational lock onto Earth, as explained in the Venus retrograde video. Since Venus has a gravitational grip on Earth, which is the cause of its unusual retrograde orbit, this could be due to Venus having been Earth's previous satellite prior to Earth getting its current moon. There are many possibilities and combinations of events and causes that could have caused Earth to have changed its moon, as stated previously. A change of a moon's size and density would have a major effect on the magnetosphere, atmosphere, and gravitational level, due to the homopolar generator effect that generates the magnetosphere, which in turn protects the atmosphere and is a major cause for the planetary axial spin. Large-scale volcanic eruptions throughout the planet caused by major Earth changes due to an expanding Earth and/or moon change. An expanding Earth's inner solid core would cause an outward force on the lava region, and subsequently the lava area would have an outward pressure on the mantle and crust, causing large-scale volcanic eruptions. This hypothesis of dinosaur extinction due to large-scale volcanic eruptions throughout the planet for an extended period was a widely accepted hypothesis throughout the science community for many decades, until the asteroid impact hypothesis was accepted as the main theory. Paleontology and geology professor Greta Keller from Princeton University is the main scientific authority in championing the dinosaur extinction by volcanic eruptions. A great article written on this subject by Blanca Bosker is in the Atlantic Online magazine titled The Nastiest Feud in Science, and it is an excellent look into the subject matter. The currently accepted asteroid impact theory can be used to explain a catastrophic event that caused Earth to be covered with clouds of smoke and more, leading to a mini ice age. However, the asteroid's size and impact area of a 111-mile-wide cavity near the Mexican town of Chicxulub on the Yucatan Peninsula is not large enough to lead to an extinction event when compared to the scale of Earth. This asteroid impact theory on its own is not enough to explain the dinosaur apocalypse and the drastic change in the size of animal life forms after the Ice Age. However, the asteroid impact event seems to be a stronger hypothesis in conjunction with the previously stated factors, like the expanding Earth, moon swap, bonsai effect, and the extended volcanic eruptions event hypotheses. These factors seem to be a better hypothesis to the dinosaur extinction than the asteroid impact theory alone. In my published book, The Ongoing Magnetic Pole Shift and Mini Ice Age, I go in depth into the causes and effects of a magnetic pole shift causing an ice age. There's also a video dedicated to explaining the magnetic pole shift and mini ice age, which will be linked in the description. The bonsai effect hypothesis factored in with the previously stated four scenarios of possible extinction causes, like the expanding and growing Earth, the moon swap, and the volcanic eruptions, the asteroid impact, and ice age, would be a better scenario for the dinosaur extinction event, in my opinion. A combination of two or more of the five stated factors is what brought about the dinosaur age extinction event. In this chapter, I present the possible causes and effects. However, the scientific community needs to study these possibilities in an open-minded manner and without attachment to old ideas, for the purpose of making better conclusions. These hypotheses need to be factored in for better scientific progress. By acknowledging these new theories and possibilities, we can use them to analyze and study the current Earth conditions and future Earth changes. An asteroid impact onto Earth during the expanding Earth changes, volcanic eruptions, and ice age is what probably sealed the fate of the dinosaur age. These new discoveries, including the bonsai effect, should be used to better prepare our civilization for future space travel and space colonization science, because the difference in the levels of gravity, magnetosphere, and atmosphere that would be found throughout the planets, solar system, and the universe needs to be factored in when planning space travel and colonization of other planets. This video is pulled from a chapter from the Dinosaur Bonsai Apocalypse book, one of a series of books which are all available on Amazon, Apple eBooks, and Barnes & Noble, and will be linked in the description.